se se adhikare janishtaha sa gunaha parikirtita viparjayastu dosaha se se adhikare janishtaha sa gunaha parikirtita viparjayastu dosaha Gauriya Goshtipati Gauriya Goshtipati Sisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told that those who are in favor of Dharma Artha Kam, they are actually Kormi. Those who are in favor of Dharma Artha Kam, they are actually Kormi. And those who want to avoid the karma fall of those actions, they are actually Gyani. Those who are in favor of Dharma Artha Kam, they are actually Kormi. And those who like to avoid karma fall, they are simply they are Gyani. Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada speaking, both of them, they are ready to make Bhagavan their servant. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada speaking, both of them, they are always busy to make Supreme Lord their servant. Bhakti is totally different thing. Usually, it is a system. As per scriptural evidence, we have documents that you will have to suffer all karma. Any action you are doing, 100% you will have to suffer karma. Who is going to suffer your karma, what you are doing? You will have to suffer. No father, no mother, no husband, no child, no. Avasvameva bhaktavyam krita karmam subhasubham. Good or bad, any kind of karma you are doing in this material world, good or bad, any kind of karma you are doing in this material world, you will have to take responsibility of that. You will have to suffer for that. Nobody going to take charge. Nahuktam khyate karmam. Nahuktam khyata karma kalpo koti satairapi. That's why it is written, avasvameva bhaktyabhyam krita karma subhasubham. Without suffering your karma fall, there is no respite. Billions of life, crores of life you can pass, but still, karma fall must be there, following you. You mean your atma. And any life, you are passing through any life, any journey, you'll have to suffer that. No respite. Only when you can do everything for Supreme Lord. The system is that, if you want to do anything and everything for Supreme Lord, that is also one kind of, you know, without any interest. That is called Gyana Mark. Karma Mark, Gyana Mark, Bhakti Mark, three marks. But in Karma Mark also, while doing karma gradually, go on doing karma, after that you feel detested. You feel detested. Horrible. Then is good symptom. But still, maybe there is one kind of smell of karma there. So no respite. And those who are Gyani, those who demand, we are Gyani, Mayavadi Gyanis. They are always speaking, we are Gyani. We are going to avoid karma. I can discuss all in details. They are speaking, we are sannyas, we are a jnani, we have no karma. Karma sannyas, you have no right in this Kali Yuga. Bhagavan Sri Krishna also can give nice argument. How you can avoid karma? Whereas your daily life, you are leading daily life. You are leading your daily life. So in daily life, you will have to do all karma. You have to take bath, go to latrine, take prasadam, do here, there, everything. Huh? How you can say this way, like foolish? You can avoid karma? You have taken karma sannyas? Foolish. It's not possible. Karma sannyas is not possible. You will have to do karma. Bhagavan Sri Krishna can give argument to Arjuna. Arjuna, even your bodily function, you have to lead your daily life. So you will have to do karma. So you cannot avoid karma. One very vital point is there. Bhagavan Sri Krishna, one by one, giving nice argument, nice judgment in front of Arjuna, so that at all Arjuna can accept the situation in which he is put into. Because he is Kshatriya, he is saying, no, I cannot do fighting. I already told, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, it is most scientific factor, not very scientific. Varnashrama Dharma is very scientific. Though I know those foreign people, they don't understand about, not about you, those are outside staying. They don't understand about what is Varnashrama Dharma. They are less interested about that. But still, Bhaktivinoda Thakur special, what miracles is there? They don't understand what is Varnashrama Dharma. But still, they are very clever. They are taking one thing from this, you know, this our scriptural analysis, one thing vital. What is that? From childhood, they are watching one boy. If you find he is very nice sportsman in childhood, they can give scope. You go up, we can give facility. He can become, well, Olympic player or World Cup player. If they find that boy is very interested to for investigation, research work, from very childhood, doing this, that, okay. Then they give facility to do some education very nicely, give some assistance, extra benefit, so that in future he can become a nice scientist. Whereas India, or in, you know, those who are, at present India is also not backward country, but I am speaking about this region, I mean, Asian region, most of them, they are not following this system. They don't understand what is the scientific meaning of what is Varnashrama Dharma. But still, they are following this thing. What is mood? What is mood? According to that, they help. That's why they can get the maximum utilization of human resource in the best possible way. You know, human resource mean for the development of country, I like to use this resource mobilization. Resource mobilization is from economics. Those who are studying in commerce and in their, you know, MCOM, they can know. Ordinary people cannot know. They know how to utilize all the minerals and everything. Minerals available here? Gold, copper, iron, so many things. So, resource mobilization means what is available in India, we can use those resources in the best possible way for the development of country. Follow? What I know? That is called, in economics, it is called resource mobilization. Very important factor. Now, those young batches there in our human society, if we like to use them in the best possible way, we can get their energy. If we can get their energy channelized in a proper way, so for the development of country, But those ministers and those foolish people, they are not utilizing. That's why we are backward. Always and everywhere, every field, even in bhajan field, they are making politics. Everywhere. Not in game, not in sports factor, in service factor, in education factor, in, you know, in anywhere. Even in bhajan field, spiritual field, they are also playing politics. So that he cannot go up, I can go up. That's why the situation created here. Actually, when Bhagavan Sri Krishna is speaking, see, Chaturvarna Maya Sishyam, Guna Karma Vibhagasa, Tasso Kartaram Opi Vidhimam Akartaram Abhayam. Chaturvarna, I make this system in this society according to Guna Vang Karma, quality and their karma. What is the mood? I segregate. But these common people, now at present, modern people, they are not actually modern. Those who understand Gita, I think they are modern. They are backward. They are not modern. They think we are smart, we are modern. Foolish number one. They are not modern. If you know the science of Gita, then I can speak loudly that you are modern. They are not modern. Follow. They're saying, even also most of the political leaders they speak, their Varnashrama Dharma is the major problem in our society. Break it. Break it, why? Krishna foolish? You are clever? They are speaking this way. They are making problem there. No system. Who is Brahman? Who is break the system. That is the problem. Government is so foolish, so foolish, so foolish. That what to speak. They reserve some seat in educational field, in service field everywhere for scheduled caste, scheduled caste. I have no objection in it. I also agree. But regarding quality, you cannot compromise. You are foolish. Okay, I can give you extra facility because you are from low caste. Scheduled caste and scheduled tribes, they are from low caste. Okay, I can give you first preference. But I cannot compromise with quality. Suppose in service, you are appearing in exam. Maybe you are Brahman. Somebody is Kshatriya, somebody is Shudra, somebody is Sidulka, Sidulta, okay. But when interview going on, when exam going on, that time quality cannot be compromised. It is not my conception, it is the conception of Gita and all Shastra. That's why present situation. With quality I cannot come. I can give you facility because you are Mataji. Okay, I can give you facility. But for that I cannot compromise with quality. If you can show same quality with that Brahman boy, maybe I can drop the Brahman boy and take you. Because you are same quality you are showing. Quality regarding efficiency in any job, and education, but for that I cannot compromise with quality. It's very important thing. That's why at present this situation. They think Krishna is foolish, they are very clever. Actually, Varnashrama Dharma is not at all making any problem. 100% I am sitting in Vyasasan, Varnashrama Dharma not at all making any important problem. Follow. Only the problem is there, the misuse of Varnashrama. Follow what I seem to say. Only the problem is there, the misuse of Varnashrama. That is the problem. They like to misuse this system. They like to misuse this system. That's why problem coming. So whom to held responsible? We cannot blame to Krishna. This is the system. And you can remember, I already told that the dharma of Kshatriya, those who are having Kshatriya quality, follow. Sourjyam teyo dhritiridaksham juddhei chapi apalayanam danam iswarabhavancho kshatkarmam sabhavajam. Kshatriyas, those Kshatriyas, they should have this quality. Sourjyam, very powerful. teyo dhitir daksham, I'm some efficiency. And they are not going to go away from battlefield. They can stand in front of battlefield. They can give their life better, but they cannot go like coward. Even in our, you know, English literature, we also know, a coward dies many times before his actual death. You hear this one? A coward dies many times before his actual death. Really so. Cowardice is, very bad. Now, one by one, Krishna going to give argument. Very nice, scientific argument. Krishna want to give judgment to Arjuna to make him establish in his duty. But Arjuna want to expose that I am Pandit. Why should I fight? Why is killing anybody is very bad? Okay. Killing anybody is very bad. Why should I kill those kith and kins there, all my relatives, everything? Why should I fight? At the same time, Arjuna speaking, Swadhim mam tam parmanyam. But it's actually not Saranagata. That's why giving this kind of argument, the soul is eternal, you see, if you kill anybody, nobody can kill nobody. Huh? Who can kill? This argument. After that, Krishna giving Sankhya-Yoga, is Sankhya-Darshan. Sankhya means, you know, Siddha Sai Baba speaking, Sammakshyate prakasayante tat vastu tatya manaya, is called Sankhya. Sankhya means Sammakshyate. Sankhya means Sammakshyate prakasayante. Siddha Sai Baba speaking, tatya vastu. The secret tattva of this material creation, the secret tattva about Atma, this material body, all this material world, Sankhya tattva, all 24 tattvas, Pancha Karmandiyo, Pancha Ganendiyo, Pancha Mahabhut, Pancha, so many things. Follow? Pancha Tanmatra, follow, Man, Buddhi, Chitta, Ahankar, this way, 27, 28 tattva you can discuss. I already discussed. While I was discussing in Purushottam months about Kapil Darshan. Shashamakshyate prakasayante tattva vastu manaya iti Sankhya Darshan. It's called Sankhya. Bhagavan Sri Krishna giving nice argument on the basis of Sankhya Tattva to help Arjuna discover his own position and go back to his original position. Follow? But still he is not ready. After that, actually, Bhagavan Sri Krishna, last day you can remember, I was speaking, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, I can give argument after, but because I like to give you a reminder about what I left before. Now I can go to Karma Yoga. What is Karma Yoga? People, they are so foolish, they like to discover fault in karma. Oh, karma is very bad, you leave karma. Leave karma? Karma is not bad. Karma, how karma is bad? Without karma, whole world going karma. But they are running in bonded condition, life after death, life after life, simply for one reason. What is the reason? Because they have some desire. You have no enemy. You have no enemy. You have the only enemy inside your heart. What is that? Your desire. Karma. Your karma, karma fall. That is going to put you in chain, bonded condition. Nobody is there. Who is your enemy? You are your own enemy. Yes. Then Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking to Arjuna. You see, Arjuna, Aschajyabhat pasyati kaschit enam aschajyabhat badati tathaiva chanyaha aschajyabhat chanyamanyaha srinauti srutyapi enam vedo na chaiva kaschit. Those who are trying to have some knowledge, some idea about what is Atma, those who are always, 29th sloka, second chapter. Those who want to have some idea, those who are trying their best to get some idea about what is Atma like, I like to know some idea, but they don't understand. Because Aschajyavat Pasyati Kaschid Enam, somebody looking, thinking about Atma is strange. Nobody can see, nobody can feel. Oh, Aschajyavat Badati Tathayvaja, somebody think it strange, somebody speak it is strange, somebody think is inconceivable. We cannot speak about Atma, we cannot pass any lecture about Atma. Somebody hearing some tattva about Atma from some realized soul, but still he is not inclined, that's why he cannot understand. Follow? Sometimes some realized soul can come in front of you by the mercy of Krishna, Nityananda. Still, it can so happen that you cannot understand him. Because you are not surrendered, you are not 100% inclined, you cannot understand. Many people coming in front of Prabhupada, Prabhupada passing lecture, but who can understand the lecture of Prabhupada? Most of the people, they are trying to understand the lecture of Prabhupada, but they couldn't, they cannot understand. So, suttapi enam, after hearing some tattva about Atma from a realized soul, still cannot understand. Srutyapi enam, Srutyapi enam, Vedanas chaiva kaschit. Follow. Eke vadanti means somebody speaking. Like this, somebody speaking like this, somebody speaking like this. Follow? That's why it is written in Upanishad, you know, Nayam Atma Prabhachane Lobhyo, Nayam Atma Prabhachane Lobhyo, no Midhaya, no Bhu, no Surteno, Jam Eva Esha Brinite Teno Lobhyo, Tashayshe Esha Atma Bibrinite Tonu Samaha. It is a strange. Up to now, in this world, if you search, how many crores of people here? If you ask, you know about Tattva? Somebody, I know Tattva. I already took education from BH University. Well, but you cannot feel. Beyond realization. Now, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, that is why Bhakti, it is the conception of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur passing remark. Nobody can understand. Nobody can understand what is Atma. They cannot have, they don't have any clear conception about Atma. Maybe they demand that we are in spiritual life, leading us which is spiritual. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. That is why different kind of conception, like Charvak, Mayavad, you know, follow this conception kind, coming, this creation. Somebody is saying, no, no, this body is Atma. No, useless. They are, those Vaishnavas, they are speaking foolish. Body is Atma, yes. Sarun said, no, this material world is false, nothing, like dream. Are you material world false? I'm sitting here, this table chair, all false. You see, all false, like dream. Nothing there. This kind of misconception about Atma growing due to not understanding the proper tattva of Atma. Follow what I say. Bhagavan Sri Krishna still giving argument, so that somehow Bhagavan Sri Krishna can engage Arjuna in his own duty. Dehi nitya abadvayam dehi sarvasya bharata tasmat sarvani bhutani nuatvam sachitum arhasi. You should not grieve over this issue. Because anybody, here any countless jiva, they are having some body, material body. Dehi nitya abadvayam. Anybody, any, you know, jivatma having anybody, you cannot kill. It's not possible. Dehi nityam abadvayam. Dehi sarvasya bharata. Not at all you can kill. So tasmat that sarvani bhutani nvatam sahi. So you should not grieve over this issue. Also, if you are, also if you at all not going to accept my, you know, idea, I mean siddhanta, still you see, if you think about your own dharma, what is your own dharma? Here Bhagavan Sri Krishna 31, last I am speaking, you see Arjuna, sadharmam api chavekshyo na vikampitum arhasi dharmad hi yudhyat cheyo anyat khatriyasya navidyate. Here Arjuna, if you look at your sadharma, own dharma, Arjuna, if you think about your own dharma, still you should not deny that I cannot fight. Why? It is your dharma. You are Kshatriya. Sadharmam api chavekshyo na vikampitum arhasi. After all, there is one argument. Dharmad hi yudhyat shreyo anyat Kshatriya sanavidyate. Righteous fighting. It's not that we are cheating with people and we want to snatch some power from somebody, that's why fighting. For a righteous fighting, this kind of where, which is present in front of you, those big, big warriors, for them, it is, you know, they are welcome. They always welcome this kind of fighting. Because nothing more important in front of those warriors. Nothing important in them, like those who are warrior group, for them nothing is important than this. Well, righteous fight. Well, you have the chance to fight. So, sadharmam api chavekshyo na vikampitum arhasi. You cannot deny. You cannot strike, I cannot fight. You are going to strike, I cannot fight. Why? So, sadharmam api chavekshyo na vikampitum arhasi dharmad hi yuddhat shreyo anyat khatriya sa navidvate. Now, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, on the basis of the commentary of Vishwanath Chakravarti and Baladev Vidyavasan, speaking nicely. There is one very important issue now we are discussing. What is that? Sadharmam. Now you can fight with me, Maharaj, what do you mean by sadharma? What do you mean by sadharma? Okay, sadharma. What do you mean by sadharma? Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving nice argument, very nice. On the basis of the commentary of Vishwanatha Chakravarti and Baladev Vidyavasan, Siddha Sai Path, all gist, Bhaktivinoda is speaking. What do you mean by dharma? First point is that those who are in bonded condition, those who are not going up to that level, for them, they have some body-related dharma because they are not out of their body conception. So their dharma is somehow material. Follow what I say. Here, what Krishna meant, actually Shadharma, I like to explain, you can go mad. Shadharma means, as per Sanskrit Vyakaran, if I speak this way, Shwa means Atma, Dharma. Follow? So what is the Dharma Atma? Shadharma. what Prabhupada speaking, the natural function of your soul is Krishna Bhakti. What do you mean devotion? Bhakti. Bhakti is a natural function. So I am not at present going up to that level. Because Arjuna is now acting in such a position, because Arjuna is not a bonded soul, surely not. But Arjuna now standing on such a platform that we find Arjuna is not going to do his own duty. Arjuna is now puzzled. Arjuna cannot take decision. Arjuna cannot understand what to do, what not to do. Krishna giving some idea, gradually. Krishna all giving scriptural evidence. Krishna not speaking anything baseless. But still, Arjuna cannot accept it. Why? Because Arjuna speaking that I am inclined, but still he is not 100% inclined. This is a system also in our bhajan life. Gurudev ki jai! But when Gurudev is speaking something, Gurudev is actually, I have some job, seva. I have to go to home quickly. Cannot do. They cannot give their life of Guru Vaishnava. That's why they cannot give life for Guru Vaishnava. That's why they cannot get Krishna. They cannot touch Bhagavad Gita. They cannot touch Salagram. They cannot touch Giridhari. You speak. There you are 100% inclined. You are acting as Acharya. You are 100% inclined. You speak. Then why you are speaking what is not spoken by Gurudev? You have no right to speak new thing. You will have to follow our Srotobani. I know your memory is very good. You can memorize a lot of scripture and speak in front of public. But what is concern to me? I am interested about your feeling. What feeling you have received in your life with the mercy of Guru Vaishnava. That is most important factor in for me. I am very much interested about this. Follow what I mean to say. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, come on. Those who are still today in bonded condition, they are not up to that level. So their dharma is also expressed according to that. They are bodily dharma, mental dharma is also there. So they need some guidance. Everybody not going to follow Bhagavad. Everybody not in a position to follow Bhagavad Dharma. Everybody can follow? No. At least they need some guidance. That's why Karma Yoga, Gyana Yoga, then so many yoga. At least you try one over and again to get in touch with that Supreme Divinity, spiritual. Try to go up and up, up and up, up and up. Then someday you can realize bhakti is the topmost thing. Without bhakti, everything useless. I can give argument, but first I will have to speak about Bhaktivinoda Thakur what speaking. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, those according to the bonded condition of jiva, they need some guidance. That's why here, their dharma is now Varnashrama Dharma. At present they are in bonded condition. Follow what I mean to say. At present they are in bonded condition, they are not free soul, they are in bonded condition. So for this, it is most scientific, this Varnashrama Dharma, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. Nobody can fight with me. Bhaktivinoda speaking, so for those bonded souls, it is obligatory for them to follow this Varnashrama Dharma. If they are going to follow this, break this system, then all mismanagement can develop like present situation. But jiva, their dharma is not Varnashrama Dharma. If it is there, then why in Chaitanya Charitamrita it is written, Eto sab chhariyar Varnashrama Dharma, eto sob chhari ar varnashram dharma. Everything you will have to leave and go and take shelter unto the lotus feet of Krishna. If varnashram dharma is final thing, if varnashram dharma is final thing, then why Bhagavan Singh is not speaking in Gita? Sarva dharmanam parityajya mam ekam saranam bhaja aham tam sarva papibhyo mokshayi shami. Ma sucha, hari? At last when Gita is over, Krishna says, no need of following varnashram, throw. Because if you attend the situation, then you can speak. Bhagavan Sri Krishna in Gita finally speaking. Sab dharma you can say, varnashram dharma, you know, mental dharma, body dharma, social dharma, all throw. No need. Only you come to mind. Mad jaji mang namaskuru. You worship me. Pay dandavat to me. Are everybody speaking, pay dandavat to me. Those big. Hey, get garland, give me. Are people misunderstand Krishna. Krishna speaking rightly. Madhyaji Mangala, foolish, speaking, worship me, is very clever. That's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming. You see, what I wanted to speak, you couldn't understand. That's why I changed my body color and mood. I'm coming in front of you to show I am a devotee. To show what is the inclination, what devotion, how we should cry for Krishna. Eh? Otherwise, why Krishna speaking? Everything you will have to leave. Eh? Then? Nayanangala sudharaya badanangadagada suddhayagira pulakoyari nichitam vapu kadatava namaka. Final thing. Eh? Is the final thing. Etosap chariyar varnasam dharma. Then you will have to show your inclination unto lotus feet of Krishna 100%. If varnashram dharma is final, then why Bhagavan Sri Krishna is speaking this way? Naam vipra na charna rupati naapi naham. This sloka, why speaking? Why? To show the topmost degree. To show the topmost degree of elevation. To show the topmost degree of elevation a jivatma can have in this life. To final target, topmost target. Na ham vipra na char narapatir na pivaishwa na sudra na hang burni na cha gyapatir na manasyatirva manasyatirva kintu pradyan nikilo parmananda purnamita dher gopi bhartur padakamayor dasu dasu. But not at present. Foolish number one. Now I cannot put you into machine to make you a gopi. There is no gopi production machine. I can put into machine, you can become gopi. You will have to hear those who are going through. I put challenge. Those who are going, they are going to follow Raganugava. Let them come. What they understand about this Gita? Yeah, no need. You throw everything. All useless. Gita, useless. Throw everything. Only try to become gopi. That is the final target. But here, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, according to your bonded condition, you need some guidance. So what guidance? That's why Bhagavan Sri Krishna arranged the system, varnashram dharma. But varnashram dharma is effective in India. Outside there are no varnashram dharma, that's why mismanagement all problem. And still they can do bhakti, because bhakti is above everything. Now actually, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking to Arjuna, Arjuna, if you think about your own duty according to varnashram dharma, it is also your duty to fight. Why you like to strike? It's not good. Bhajan sadharmam upichaviksho na vikampitam arhasi dharmad hi yuddhat shreyo anyat khatriyasya navidyate. Follow? After that, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, Jadrichaya chopapannam sargadharam apavritam shukhinaha khatriyaha partho labhante yuddhamidrisham. Yuddhamidrisham. Idrisham yuddha, this kind of fighting. You know, those who are big, big fighter, warrior, they are, you know, praying Jadrichaya chopapannam sargadharam apavritam. The gateway to sarga is open to you. And for Kshatriya, nothing is more than this opportunity that you are going to get, go to heaven. If you are at all going to die. Because jadrichaya, without craving, without, you know, it is, you know, soliciting. You are not praying without any demand coming in front of this opportunity. Follow. Without any soliciting. You are not going to solicit. Jadrichaya manu, without any demand, without any, you know, expectation coming in front of you. Jadrichaya cha upapannam. Upapannam mean coming in front of you this opportunity. Sargodharam apavritam. This gateway to sarga is open before you. Sukhinaha khatriyaha partho lavante yuddhamisa. Those who are khatriya, warrior group, they are always, always expecting this kind of, you know. They give honor to this kind of. Or Arjun, at all, if you don't like to, now, you can put some argument. You are speaking this way, but you think about me, my position, Arjun speaking, how I can fight with those, you know, senior person, I mean my relatives, how I can fight? Eh? Whereas I know killing anybody is very sinful. You are going to engage me in fighting? Whereas killing anybody is sinful, but you are going to engage in fighting. How I can kill those, you know? That's why Krishna giving this argument. This kind of fighting is, oh, luck. Luckily you can get in your life. This is in front of you. This opportunity coming in front of you. This kind of opportunity coming in front of you. Although, or still, you are not going to obey me, atho chetvam imam, atho chetvam imam, atho chetvam imam, dharmam sangramam na karishvasi, tataha sadharmam kirtincha hitva papam avapsasi. Avapsasi means you can get sin. Follow. You can get sin. Why? Because if you reject, if you don't like to fight, if you refuse to fight this righteous way, then striking your duty and losing your reputation, you will incur sin. Simply you are going to incur sin. Be careful. You will have to do, you will have to follow your own duty. Atho chet tvam imam. Split up. Atho chet, chet mani jodi. If, atho chet imam, dharmam, sangramam, na karishyasi. Tataha sadharmam kirtin cha hitva. Papam abhavsasi. Hitva mane living. You are going to lose your dignity, everything. If you want to strike, don't like to fight. It's also dangerous for you. Also, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, akirtin chapi bhutvani kathaishvanti te abhayam swam bhavitasya chakirtir maranat atirichyate. What is written? See carefully. Akirtin chvapi bhutani, akirtin chvapi bhutani kathaishvanti te abhayam. Swambhavitasso chvakirtir maranat atirichyate. Maranat atirichyate. Nay, people will also pour undying infamy on you. They are going to criticize, useless. An infamy brought on to a man who is enjoying popular esteem. Follow. Infamy brought on a man who is enjoying popular esteem in this society is more than death. It is better before death you die. Those are honorable person, if they hear all rubbish from common people, what they? Follow. Akittin chapi bhutani katheishvanti, they can speak all rubbish against you. Akittin chapi bhutani katheishvanti te abhayam. And sambhavita so chakirtir manarad atirichyate. Maranad atirichyate. More than death. It is better to meet with death. Now, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, they can speak all rubbish. Bhayad ranad uparatam mangshante tvam maharathaha yesanchatam bahumato bhutvya yasasi laghavam. Those big warrior captains, they can think you are coward. That's why you are flying from this battlefield. Follow. You are covered. They can pass this kind of remark. Those captain, big manager, big captain of this is battlefield. They can pass this. Hey, coward. That's why going away from battlefield. Bhayad ranad uparatam mangsante. Bhayad ranad uparatam mangshante tvam maharathaha. Maharathaha many big captains, big atirath, maharath, they are organizing thousands of warrior, controlling, taking control. They can pass as a coward, that's why gone. Bhayad ranad uparatam mangshante, they can think this way. Bhayad ranad uparatam mangsante tvam maharatha. Yesham chutam bahumato bhutya. Previously they used to honor you very much. Those captains, previously they used to give you big honor. But now, if they find you are going away from this battlefield, they can see it's a coward. And they can speak all rubbish against you. You like to hear all rubbish against? Abaccha vadangscha bahuna badishvanti tava ahitaha nindantastava swamartham tato dukshataram nukim. What can be more painful than this, that they can express all rubbish remarks against you? Avacha, they should not speak this kind of rubbish things against you, but still, if they speak, you can expect this kind of thing? Avacha vadangscha bahuna badishvanti tava ahitaha nindantastava swamartham tato dukshataram nukim. What can be more painful than that? They can speak all rubbish against you. So it is better, I am giving last argument to you, you see. Better you die, fight and die. Or if you come victory, enjoy total sovereignty all over the world. Victory, okay. Two options. One is that you die and go to heaven. Or if you come out successful, victory, you can enjoy the total sovereignty all over the world. Hato va prapsasi sargam jitya va bhakshase mahim Tasmad uttishta kantiyo judhayo kritanischayo. Try to settle down your mind. Try to settle down your mind for fighting. Don't put any argument. Hato uba prapsasi sargam. If you are at all going to die in battlefield, you are going to heaven, no problem. Jitva va bhakshashe mahi, or you at all come out victory, you can get the total sovereignty over this world. So what's wrong in it? Tasmat, that's why I am requesting you, get up. Tasmat uttishta kuntiyo, yuddhayo krita nischayo, try to settle down, take resolution, well I can fight, but you are not. Now Bhagavan Sri Krishna, up to when second chapter starting, from their Sankhya-Yoga speaking, and some Gyan-Yoga. Now Bhagavan Sri Krishna going to speak about the secrecy of Karma-Yoga. What is the technique of Karma-Yoga? What is the main technique, secrecy of Karma-Yoga? Adopting which you are not going to get any sin, though you kill. Because it is your duty, you are Kshatriya. Shukhe duk. This is the main formula. Try to digest in your life. Many times I told before, in different form, different way. Shukho dukhe shame kritva labha labho jaya jayo tato yuddhayu yuddhasyo naivam papam avapsasi. No, you are not going to get an incur any sinful act. No, not at all. But what is the technique? Sukho dukhe shame. You are actually oscillating factor. Ah, very pain. I'm going to kill them. No, you have to leave everything. If you can attain this position in this life, if you have your power, if you are enjoying the full power of Guru Vaishnava, Kripa, then try to follow this formula in your life, this life. Don't wait for next life. Who can say this opportunity you are getting this life? Who can say you are going to lose this opportunity next life? No guarantee. So try to utilize this life. Don't wait. So sukha dukhe shame kritva, try to attain this equipoised situation, balanced position, where somebody going to give honor, somebody going to insult, all same. Sukha dukho. Sukha dukhe shame kritva. Lava, lava, jaya, jau. What is the gain? What is the loss? Same thing. What is the victory? What is the failure to attain victory? All the same. You have your duty to fight, so you fight. Why you are thinking about karmapal? Don't. You have no right. You can remember three classes before I am speaking. First, karmanni vadhikaraste ma phaleshu kadachana. I was speaking this? You have a right to do your duty. Why you are thinking that I have ma Maharaj, I am doing something, I must expect something? No Maharaj, I have no expectation. You stop my speech, I can go away. No expectation. Any kind of expectation is there, it is one kind of contamination. Follow? Oh Maharaj, he is doing business to make profit without any expectation. Why he should do business? He is going to play in the battle, in the playing ground. Okay. Or somebody, in one country fighting with other, they have some target. They like to come victory. So without any target, without any expectation, without any result, who mad is there going to do any job? Even if I say, hey, go down. Why, Maharaj? Why I can go down? You can ask me. So without any reason, nobody going to do anything. Mandadhir opi na pavartante. Pavartante. Mandadhi. Was brain almost gone out of over. Still, if you speak something, he is thinking, what is the utility? Why should I do? He is thinking about this. Huh? Without any expectation, without any result, expectation, who is going to do what? You can speak, Maharaj is a madly conception, madly conception. This is a technique, very fine technique, what Krishna is speaking. If Arjuna can understand, then all problems solve. What is this? I can give you an example. In childhood, up to boyhood, or we are playing football, this, that, all the time. Every day playing. 6 hours, 7 hours. Morning time, noon time. Hey, read! Ah, I can read fast, I like to play. This kind of planning. So, extreme affinity for playing. So, those who are boys, those who are, you know, small children, they are playing. Now, they are making two groups. Two groups playing. But in playing, somebody can come victory, somebody can come. Cannot be victory. So, they are playing. Why? They are making two groups. They are making two groups. They are playing with each other. Some can come out successful, some can get defeated. So, what problem? Follow? Before starting their playing, they are going to write in paper about their what is the result of our playing this, that. So, small children, small boys, they are playing. Why playing? What is the reason? What you can get out of playing? Maharaj, I like to play, that's why I'm playing. What is the reason? I cannot say. Follow. What is the reason? Why those boys playing? You cannot understand. Playing, they like to play. That's why they are playing. No result, no businessman can calculate how what result can come out of this playing. So this is that. So while Krishna speaking, there must be scientific ground. Now Krishna speaking all scientific, very, very sensitive point. If Arjuna can understand, he can get ready, well, I can fight. But still Krishna going to give argument. There is a technique of karma yoga. What is that technique? Because those who are doing karma, they have some result. And I can explain after two or three slokas. That is the greatest danger in your life. That is the greatest danger in your life, that you are fostering some idea. You are fostering some idea. I mean, you are fostering, you are expecting some result. Oh, I can marry, I can live this life this way. Of course, you have. This is what? One kind of bondage. This is great, this is the topmost danger, greatest danger in life. Shuko, shuko dukhe shami kritva labha labho jaya jayo tato yudhayo yudhasyo. To fight, you must fight. Why I can fight? To fight, you must fight. You will have to fight, that's why you have to fight. I'm not going to hear anything. You will have to fight because you have to fight. No reason. If you have some argument, have some expectation, there is one kind of bondage. Then you can never become free from sinful activities. Follow what I say. Those who have not any expectation, their mind, their situation is totally equipoised, balanced situation, then never mind. If they are doing any activities, for they are not going to incur any sin. Because they are equipoised, balanced. They are on such a neutral position, no amount of mental material torture can put them in trouble. Hiranyakasipu, so much torture going to Prahlad Maharaj. Prahlad Maharaj never angry. Prahlad Maharaj never expressing any angry to you. Prahlad Maharaj expressing any? No. Prahlad Maharaj is always happy. Always humble. The humble mood. Speaking with Hiranyakasipu. So any amount of torture could not eat any expectable result. Hiranyakasipu could not do anything. So Prahlad Maharaj's situation, sukha dukhe sami kritva labha labhau jaya jayau tato yuddhaya yuddhaso, to fight you will have to fight. Reason you don't play your head. Reason you don't play your head. Yuddhaya yuddhaso naivam na evam na evam papam avapsasi. You are not at all going to incur any sin. Actually, you can remember, those who are doing anything, service, business, education or anything, they are yajna, they are doing, na? Especially those Vedic activities, yajna or any vrata, you have taken resolution, I can this do this. Amount of, you know, brata, this, after that I want to get that thing. Hiranyakasipu doing astutian finances. No bhuto, no bhavishyati. But result? Mahatma speaking, hey, those who are demon, they are also doing astutian finances. What can go and come? Huh? Osuro tap kare tahe kiba phal. Foolish. What do you think? Mahaprabhu speaking to Suklambar Brahma, Suklambar Brahmachari. He is only taking milk. No rice, no chapati, no sweet ball, no paramanna, nothing. Only taking what? Milk. Mahaprabhu became very angry. Hey, what do you think? Those who are demons, they are doing astutian finances a long time. No bhuto, no bhavishyati. You think by astutian vimansa you can get me? Foolish? Without bhakti nobody can get me. Bhakti is the only way to get me. If you can love Guru Vaishnava, Bhagavan, Krishna, surely you can get Krishna. Now point is that those who are doing jagya, suppose I am speaking, those who are doing service, this, that, they leave it. And for the time being, they have some expectation, I can, month is over, I can get 60,000 salary, this amount I can put in bank, this amount I can give to wife for running family, this one I can spend for for my children, for education, this way. They have some budget, you see, calculation, they have some expectation. But here, actually any kind of yajna, any kind of vrata you are doing, if you are not successful, you are not going to complete, you cannot get result. Follow. Not only that, you can get bad result. Follow. That is why Prithu Maharaj was very annoyed. Prithu Maharaj was disturbed. I cannot complete my 100 asamay yajna. Oh my God! 99 over. One yajna I cannot complete. Indra, let me see what Indra is like. Let me see who Indra is. Huh? He is making problem. But somehow Indra stealing horse, making problem. Why? Indra don't allow approval, not going to approve 100 asamay yajna. Because his name is Shatakratu. Indra enjoying this name, Shatakratu. My name is Shatakratu. If somebody doing 100 asamay yajna, then this record is failed. So now in whole world in the Guinness book chart, he is the tallest man in the world. He is this way. Guinness book of world, you are going to put your name. Ah, Maharaj, I can do this or that. So, you see, so everybody like to enjoy some reputation. without honor, without reputation, without, you know, name, fame and position, even Indra is not like to do anything. Even somebody doing, they like to make disturbance so that he cannot complete his hundredth yagya is over, 100 yoga. Repeatedly problem finish, problem making, then Prithvi, hey, you call Indra and throw Indra into fire. You are Brahmin, powerful, you have no power, you call Indra and throw into fire. Then Indra coming by the fire, by the power of mantra, Indra coming on fire, falling, going to die. Then Bhagavan coming and saying, Indra, why you are interested to complete your 100 jagya? You are actually full of bhakti. What jagya can do? One jagya is less, okay, no problem. What is the ultimate goal of jagya? To satisfy me. I am already satisfied with you. Let one jagya less in your life, so what problem? So you try to compromise. You try to make friendship with Indra. Indra says, you cannot kill Indra. You should not kill. He is the heaven king. You should not kill. So make a friendship with king. Let one jagya less in your life, what problem? Then one less jagya is over. So everybody interested to do their jagya. Why? Even in the Bali Maharaja's jagya, you can remember, I am giving one or two examples. Why? To get clear idea. Bali Maharaja's jagya was totally disturbed in middle. Bali Maharaja's jagya was disturbed in middle. Why? In the meantime, Vamandev came expecting 3 footsteps on land. After that, his big bass, whole world grabs. No place, where you can? Third place, third step, where to speak? You speaking lie? Bale, Maharaj, when you came here, your footstep was so small. Now you are saying this. When you came to me, your footstep was so small. You are small Brahman. This was this much. So I was agree. Now you are showing this whole world you are taking. What I can do? Then after that, Bindavali, the wife of Bali Maharaj, was very clever. He giving advice to husband. Why not you give your head? Okay, Prabhu, I can give your head. Give my head to put your third leg. Well, so you see, so clever. That is called Dharmapatni. Dharmapatni is so clever, can save husband from danger. So, Bali Maharaj cannot calculate what to do, what not to do. Vrindavali coming, give advice to husband. Why not you speak this way? There's one place here, my head. You put your, you are lucky. Then, Bhamandev is going to put his head, leg on the head of Bali Maharaj. So lucky Bali Maharaj is. But Bali Maharaj was disturbed. Why? Because the jagya itself break down in middle. In middle there's, because jagya not yet completed. Jagya not yet completed. So in between jagya, if somehow jagya disturbance there, there is big problem. You will have to get feedback. Big problem. Not that, oh Maharaj, my so many expenses gone. Not that. Expenses gone, time gone, all gone. At the same time, you will have to get bad result. Get feedback, be careful. Follow what I say. But for this karma yoga system, the technique of karma yoga, anyway, you are not going to get punishment. If you are perfect, if you are perfectly following karma yoga, then no problem. Now Bhagavan going to give same thing what I am explaining in front of you for long time. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking. Eshate avihita sankhye buddhi yoge tu imam srinu. Buddhya yukto yaya partho karma bandhyam prahasasi. Hey partho, I was speaking about sankhya yoga, sankhya gyan. Now I am speaking about bhakti yoga sandhini. It has some touch of bhakti in this karma yoga. I mean, buddhi, vyavasayatika buddhi. Karma yoga. What is the technique here I am speaking? So long I was speaking about, you know, karma. I was speaking all about karma, you will have to do this, that. After that, Gyan, Sankhya, Yoga. Now, bhakti-oriented is technique, this karma yoga. And this kind of, you know, intellect, if you develop, you can live a whole world. Now, no problem of this world can touch you. Vice or virtue, you know, pain or pleasure, nothing can touch you. I promise you. So, you see, this is a technique. Eshate avita. Eshate avita. Shankhe buddhi yoge tu imam sanu. Buddhya yukto jaya partho karma bandham prahasasi. It's called karma yoga, the technique I am seeking. So also from Upanishad you can find, many times I told, those who are greedy, those who somehow cannot go out of the material bondage, they are always thinking, I can do this, that this, enjoy this thing, that thing. But Upanishad giving warning. Isha vashyamidam sarvam yat kinti jagadam jagat teno tekteno bhunjitha ma griddhaka siddhanam. Any kind of thing you are getting in your life, be it your cloth, be it the fruits, be your sweet, anything in your life you are getting, you can think it is the prasadam of Krishna. Can you think this way? Cannot think. You have to go up to that level. Those who are elevated Vishnu, for them, anybody think giving anything to him, he thinks it is prasadam. Even we are explaining in Vrindavan, Bhagavad Katha, Harikatha, nothing is there available in Vrindavan, fruits or sweets, anything which is not Uchishta. Because Krishna is always taking Uchishta. In Vrindavan, you cannot show me any sweet shop, any birds coming and entering into showcase and taking sweet and gone. Then Krishna can take. Yes. They are not monkey coming, taking fruits. They are not beating. So in Vrindavan, everything Uchishta. Krishna likes to take Uchishta. So, Isavasya Midam Sarvam, you can realize. That is very excellent idea. Anything in your life coming, any cloth, or any garment, anything, any room, any facility, all prasadam. Palladma singing, Maharaj Nishingadev giving forcefully me. This is one prasadam of Nishingadev. I don't like to get control over this, you know, I don't like to rule. Because I like to do bhakti. Oh, no, you have to do it, says. Yudhishthira Maharaj less interested about this, you know, sovereignty. But it is the prasadam of Krishna. This kingdom, this sovereignty getting, this is the prasadam of Krishna. That's why Yudhishthira Maharaj somehow want to control himself. Because Yudhishthira Maharaj at all don't like to stay here. Like to leave this minute. But still is prasadam. So anyway, we have to prasadam, you see. So, ishavasyam idam sarvam yat kinchit jagadam jagat teno taktena bhunjitha ma griddhaka sasiddhanam. Anything coming in your life, any ornament, any money, anything coming in your books, anything, fruits, anything, is a prasadam sent by Krishna. That's why the big opulences of Yudhishthira Maharaj is not a matter of bondage. That is why the big opulences in the life of Amrish Maharaj is not a matter of bondage. That is why the big opulences is not a bondage for Parikshit Maharaj, Prithu Maharaj. Because they are realized. They are realized so they can realize everything coming from Krishna. Who am I? Who am I? I am going to leave this body. I am going to leave this body. So I don't like to get control over the society. I don't like to become a leader, spiritual leader. The simple thing I can do, the delegation of authority, the delegation of authority given by Guru Maharaj to speak Harikatha. Gurudev, Santu Goswami Maharaj, Bon Baba, Bhaktivalabhutitva Goswami Maharaj, Giri Maharaj, Bhaktivadan Sagar Maharaj, Satya Govinda Maharaj, all big Vaishnava, they give you order, speak Harikatha. That I can do. I cannot become a spiritual leader, big leader. Come on, no? Speak Harikatha, okay. My Harikatha can prove that I am servant of my Gurudev. My Harikatha, speaking Harikatha, is the topmost servitorship of Gurudeva Prabhupada. This much. I am the topmost servant. I am trying to become. I am not topmost, I am trying to become. So, from Upanishad also you are going this same idea. Upanishad also speaking same idea to you, same. But here actually Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking to Arjuna. You see Arjuna, if you are going to follow your sadharma, then there is no danger in your life. Why? Because I already told, if you are going to do any activities, follow. If the yoga is not complete, if brata is not complete, you are not going to get result. At the same time, you are going to get feedback. But it's karma yoga. For that, you are not going to suffer anything. Why? Why? If doksha karma yoga is not complete, then, but no. For that, if karma yoga, if your karma yoga is perfect, then you are not going to get any bad result. Why? Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, Nehavik kamanasho asti pratabhayo navidvate salpam opiyasya dharmasyo trayate mahato bhayat. Salpam, follow, salpam asti asya dharmasyo. Kasya dharmasyo? Varnashrama dharmasyo? It is your duty, you are Kshatriya. So, salpam opi asya dharmasyo. Kasya dharmasyo? Varnashrama dharmasyo? It is your duty to fight. Salpam opi, if you do little bit, not successful, still, salpam opi asya dharmasyo, trayate mahato bhayat. It can save you from great danger. This month, suppose you are not successful, up to this point you do, okay. But still going this amount, going to save you from great danger, mahato vayat. Why? What is the great danger? What do you mean by great danger? That danger, now I like to explain. What is the danger? Vishwanath Chakravartivad, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Baladev Vidya Bhushan, Siddhasana, they are all speaking. What is the danger? What danger is speaking about? What kind of danger? No danger is there. Yes, danger is there. What danger? That's why speaking, Nehavik kamanaso asti pratabhayo navidvate. Pratabhayamane, if you are not successful, you will have to get bad result. Feedback. Pratabhay. I am not successful, so I have to get result. Bad result. But this, you know, exact if you split up, what is the meaning? Nehavikramanasho, na iho avikramanasho sti. Pattabhayo navidvate. No problem. If you go up to this point, still it is concrete. Up to that point is concrete. Still, this amount of, you know, sadharma going to save you from great danger. Also, you can remember many times I explain, I have no right to snatch your duty. Again, I like to touch that factor. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing in Jaiva Dharma, Chaitanya Sakshamrita, you are given paramarthik brahmanatva. You are given skirt thread, huh? you are giving paramarthik brahmanatva, but you have no right to go to society and snatch the duty of all brahman. Follow what I mean to say? You are giving skarte to do bhajan. To do bhajan. Or at all you can do something, jagya, everything in mot. You have no right to go to market and do yagya and everything and do everything and snatch the duty of brahman. Because it is they are going to earn their bread. Those brahman, they are going to earn their bread this way. Of course, at least if they are actually brahman. At present, totally mismanagement. A brahman going to open one shoe shop. You are laughing. Yes, Mr. Banerjee, there is shoe shop. Everybody coming, let me see your leg size. I can give shoe. Is duty? What is the duty of brahman? Is not doing. Is the duty of kshatriya? I already told, is not doing. So nobody going to follow their own duty. That is the main problem here. So you have no right to snatch the duty of others. Those who are Shudra, those who are leather man, they are going to do. You are actually Vaishya, you can do some business. You are actually Kshatriya, you can do some other job. You can join in military or do something. But you are going to break all system and like to follow fanciful attitude. Your fanciful attitude. That's why all mismanagement here. So I already give example. One joking you already told, na? One day one thief came in one house, one dog and one ass was there. So that, you know, the house owner is sleeping. But at daytime, the house owner beat the dog very much without any reason. No reason. The dog saying, today I am striking. I am not going to do my duty. Because I am not getting bread today. I am fasting, so I cannot do my duty. Now thief coming, then ass speaking, hey, you shout, shout. Then your master sleeping. But I cannot, I am not, today I am striking. I cannot do my duty. Then what to do? Then thief coming and stealing. Then that, you know, ass shouting, hack, or shouting. then the master coming out his street and beat, idiot, I give you so much khawa, you know, grass, everything, now you're starting, now time, beat, and break his head, and gone inside and sleeping. The dog laughing, not saying, what? It is my duty. You are doing my duty, that's why you are getting beating. It was my duty to shout, now you are going to take my charge, so you are beaten heavily. Follow. So we have no right to snatch the duty of others. You have your own duty you can do. In family also, wife has his own duty, man in husband one duty, daughter, children, they have own duty, they can perform own duty. Now the society speaking, actually man and woman same right. Okay, I am also right. I am also ready to confess. Man and woman same right. Those foolish ministers, they are speaking. I already write in Gomata book. You are speaking that man and woman same right. Okay, I am also agree. Man and woman same right. Then why you are going to arrange special train for woman? Lady special, why? You just told same man and woman, same right. Why you are arranging? It's not possible. Same right, it was there in Vedic Yuga. In Vedic Yuga, that time woman, they are getting so much respect because dignity was that up to that level. All women, they have their respective dignity up to that level. No, foolish people. What dignity they are showing? Those women, they outside, what dignity they are saying? Eh? What dignity they are saying? How they can demand same? It is not possible. What is written in Shastra, you cannot ignore. You are going to ignore Shastra, that's why you are getting this kind of problem. It is written in Manu Sanghita, Veda, women, they are going to get great dignity. They have right to study everything. But not there, they can kick husband and go and lead their life and say, not there. They have some system. But husband should be like that. Not that husband can do all rubbish and wife can give honor, not that. There's such a system. But I am speaking that there is no system at present. Vedic system is so rules and regulation there. Now there's a Vedic Varnashram. Vedic Varnashram. Vedic Varnashram, what do you understand by Vedic Varnashram? What do you mean? You are following in rubbish, rules and regulation in the name of Vedic Varnashram. Daiva Varnashram, what do you understand by Daiva Varnashram? What do you understand? You are explaining wrongly? I am making some problem all over the society, all over the world? Foolish number one? Now Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, Vyavasayatvika Buddhi. Vyavasayatvika Buddhi Re Keha Kuru Nandana Bahu Shakahi Anantasya Buddhayo Avyavasayinam. Vyavasayatvika Buddhi. What do you mean Vyavasayatvika Buddhi? What do you mean? Whose brain is totally settled down. I will have to go this way. Fix up. This way I will have to go. No changing mood anytime, oscillating, say, oh, this situation, what to do? I can change. No. Vyavasayatvika Buddhi. What kind of Vyavasayatvika? Vyavasayatvika Buddhi Re Keha Kuru Nandana. Hey Kuru Nandan, Arjun, Vyavasayatvika Buddhi, whose brain is settled down, has one channel, not multiply channel, one channel, through which, one direction. That's why speaking, Vyavasayatvika Buddhi Rekeha, Rekeha. Vyavasayatvika Buddhi Rekeha Kuru Nandana. Bahu Shakahi Anantascha Buddhayo Avyavasayinam. Those who are their brain not settled down, their brain channelized in different channel. Going this business, this business, this here house, this factor, all multiply channel. Their brain is channelized. So they are chanchal. Chanchal means automatically chanchal. If your brain is not settled down, if you are not channelized, automatically you are chanchal. You can show some chanchal attitude. Restless situation. This way, actually, Viswanath Chakotipad, Baladevi Darshan, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Shida Saipad, they are speaking all nicely about all these topics. Who is going to show Vyavasayatvika Buddhi? Who is not? There's a great issue. Big. So how to understand? How to understand that his brain is Vyavasayatvika Buddhi? His brain is not Vyavasayatvika. How to understand? Actually, activities. His activities can prove. Follow? Actually, activities, all his activities can prove. He says, Vyavasayatvika Buddhi, he is settled down. Or chanchal. Or Vyavasayatvika Buddhi. Somebody explained, Vyavasayatvika Buddhi means not business. Business, Bengali, actually, business, if you translate into Bengali, Vyavasa. It is not that. Somebody got, I learned business. I learned Bengali. It is business. No. Totally separate meaning here. Sanskrit, Bengali is so sensitive language. So day by day we'll have to hear. In this respect, German people, they were very, high. Because all along they are following Indian culture. I mean, Vedanta, they are studying still today. German topmost. Max Muller, you heard the name of Max Muller. So, now whole world trying to understand something, but still not response not coming too much. We want to get response, but where is that kind of preacher? One speech gone like bullet. One speech gone can touch heart and change life. Follow? Yes. So you see, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Vyavasayatmika buddhi rekeha kurunandana bahu shakahi anantascha buddhayo avyavasayinam. Those people, if their brain not settled down, they are going to put their efforts in different channel. Yes, still today. You come with me, I can show to Gautam. He is opening so many business. So many business, one man is running. Sometimes this business, sometimes this business. He puts some man in there. How much money you need to lead your life? I don't know. Police people. I'm laughing. How much money you need? Still today you are restless. Billions of dollars you collect from foreign country. Why not you sit in one place and try to guide yourself and try to guide others? Why you are running to collect money? Why? What money can do? Foolish number one. Going here and there collect money. Preaching. What preaching? Foolish. This money can kill you. This money. Appliances of Ravan killed him. Appliances of Hiranyakashipu killed him. We are going to lead Niskinchan life. Prabhupada was Niskinchan. Though he established 64 different modes, Sri asks, Prabhupada is Niskinchan, I have nothing. You cannot look, your sight cannot go up to that far. Whole Mayapur land was the property of Radha Govinda Ji, Chaitanya Mahat. Now all gone. But still, Prabhupada thinking, I am Niskinchan, I am beggar. Nothing going to touch. A realized Vaishnava, who is elevated Vaishnava, in their life, if this kind of opulence is coming, still they not going to show any kind of discrimination. Nothing going to touch them. Prahlad Maharaj, oh, is the order of Nishingadeva, what to do? Is the order of Dhruva, you know, Prabhu, Hari, so Dhruva Maharaj. Dhruva Maharaj speaking, Prabhu, it's enough of it. Now I have the chance to see your lotus feet. I want nothing. Okay, you want nothing, but still, you have to obey my order. You have to take. Prahlad speaking, Prabhu, what I can do with these opulences, this kingdom? No, you will have to. So this is the prasadam of Nishingadev. This is the prasadam of Hari. This kind of feeling can be there. If I deposit 10 lakhs rupees in your name, that tomorrow I can find you are going to pay. Hey, who are you? 10 lakh rupees, nothing. Bonded souls, so bad condition. Bonded souls, so bad condition, they cannot digest. So never try to deposit money in bank. Krishna is there to save you. To organize big mart, you need deposit. For family life, deposit need some, Mahaprabhu speaking. Not for those who are running their renounced order. They as such don't need. If at all something is there, okay, you should believe on Krishna. Krishna is going to give you. If Krishna don't like, okay, no problem. You should be satisfied in any situation. Any situation, you should be satisfied. Okay. It's the arrangement of Krishna, what to do. First time, Swami Maharaj going, not getting any result. Coming back, failure, total. Okay, it is the arrangement of Krishna, maybe. Second time I can go. This way, actually, now next day I can explain. Now next day I am just going to recite this sloka only. Now I am going to recite this sloka, not explain. I can explain next day. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking to Krishna, Arjuna. Bhagavan Sri Krishna going to explain this to Arjuna. Jamimam puspitam bacham pravadanti apipaschitaha Vedo-vado-rataha partho-nanyad-asti-iti-vadinaha. Yamimam Puspitam Vacham. Puspitam Vacham means totally, you know, full of flower, decorated. Inner meaning that the Vedic literature full of, you know, flowers can give you lucrative offer. Oh, if you can do this yoga, you can get a son in your life. Oh, really? I can do Pratyashri yoga? If you do this, you can become a king of this kingdom this way. This is a different kind of lucrative offer. Lucrative, no? Lucrative offer? Veda going to say, oh, if you do this yoga, you can get all power. If you do this yoga, you can get this power, that power. You can go to heaven even after. This way, Veda always going to show you some lucrative offer. That is called Jamimam Puspitam Bacham Prabhadanti Abhipaschitaha. Those who cannot see past, present or future, those who are not, their brain is not settled down, they can make mistake to follow the offer of Krishna. In this material world also, big company, they're giving offer. Oh, if you keep money, we can give 15%, you know, interest to you. 20% is interest. Within 5 years, we can get double amount. All pure people say, how much I can earn? Better I can keep this money here. After that, that's it. That company is cheater company. Bas, all money gone. Billions of dollars gone. Poor people, sometimes they are going to commit suicide because they keep money. They can give arrange marriage of their daughter, but that company is cheater company. Most of the company in market, they are cheater company. They are giving you lucrative offer. If you keep money with us, we are going to show you this benefit. You are going to step into this offer, then you are tapped, you are in tap. All money gone. Those who are involved in this, you know, connection, those who are involved, if, you know, Krishna can arrest them, you can show, oh, so honorable person, they are involved in this, you know, in this cheating case. They are involved, big man. They are involved in this cheating case. Poor man. A whole life they earn 10 lakhs maximum, 5 lakhs. Poor man, they're going to give marriage, arrange marriage, oh, all money gone, going to suicide. Now how I can live? So this is the system, you see. So I started with what? What sloka I started with? Se se adhikari janishtaha guna parikartita. Viparyas sudoshah jamimam puspitam bacham prabadanti vipaschitah vedo vadaratah partho nanyad asti vadinah vancha kalpatrosik vasana. If you cannot read this Gita, how we can read Bhagavatam? Like wind you will have to read. His tongue should be like water. His tongue of Brahman like water. You can read like wind, Bhagavatam sloka. So you have to learn. So any question? No? What question? No question. Okay. I give answer to all questions actually. No question. Grandmother, understand everything? Very nice. Huh? What?
I have a question that's not regards to this class.
Huh?
Is it okay?
Huh? What?
She has another question, but it's not connected with this class.
Acha, acha. What question?
I was asking, I wanted to ask you, when you have a lot of deities, is it okay to put them to sleep?
So from distance, I cannot hear. Click.
Oh.
Speak clearly. Huh.
And you want to do your bhajan, is it okay to put them to sleep?
You like to, is me serving so many deities.
She can put them to sleep.
No, actually hear me. In Kalikal, I already told you, those who are attaining that kind of stage, to touch Salagram and Giriraj, I am not Sahajya. All the whole world can leave me. Still I am not going to change my decision. My Guru Maharaj used to speak this way, if you attain that kind of situation, maintain purity, you can do service. And if there is so many duties, deities, you cannot arrange sleeping of all deities. Follow? All deities, you cannot arrange sleeping of all deities. In temple, we arrange only maybe some small deities, Radha Govinda. Oh, close in one box.
Because then she can have more time for chanting and for listening.
Oh, acha. Actually, this depends upon.
Because she's sick also.
Huh?
She has so many deeds, but she's sick.
Acha. So then, when you are sick, then you have no right to serve deity. People cannot guide you right this way. My Guru Maharaj used to speak. Those who are not attending up that kind of situation. Suppose Rajaguna, Tamaguna is there. Not, I am not speaking about you. Anybody. Those having Tamaguna, Rajaguna. It is written in Haribhakti Vilas, those who are going to touch Salagram, Salagram speaking as if he is putting knife on me. Knife. Salagram says, those who are Tamaguna, they are going to touch me, Salagram speaking, in Haribhakti Vilas, as if they are going to put knife on me, my body. I feel so pain. At least you said attain Brahman, everybody misguiding. Misguiding. Before worshipping, you must attain that kind of quality. Though you can speak this way, Maharaj, worshipping is Kanishtha Adhikari. Okay? So what? Kanishtha Adhikari mean? It's a duty of Kanishtha. Okay? But still, you must maintain purity of your mind, because worshipping, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Prabhupada speaking, worshipping means some of your mind is oriented, this mind should be pure, and matter is also oriented, Prabhupada speaking. In worshipping, this procedure, some of your mind, pure mind, and some external matters also oriented about your worshipping. So how you can purify? That's why Mahaprabhu is saying, Kalikale, Nam bina nahi ko upaya. That's why the easiest procedure in Kali Yuga is to do Harinam Sangha. Many times I am speaking to Anandamaya, all devotee. Try to leave everything and come and attend Harikatha, but they are not going to obey me. They are not going to obey me. So I am not responsible for any of their activities. They can do what they like. I say leave everything. Come here, attend Harikatha. Your Sivji is not problem. Only wonder about this. Aman. There is not big problem. Because everybody's house, it cannot go. I think if you are shooting, okay. Sometime if you problem, then you can speak me. Sivji Maharaj is a very, if you give one wonder about, become very happy. Sometime become angry. So you can speak. Thakurji, actually, you never asked me before getting deities, you never asked me. So now it is your duty to give deity to somebody who can take charge. Not at all. In family life, somebody sometimes, she is sick, he can take care. Sometimes he is sick, she can take care. But you are alone. So, not possible. Deity means Giriraj. Who deity? Huh? Radha Krishna. Who established? It is installed already? By somebody?
Yes, Radha Krishna, eight Sakhi.
Oh my God! Even I cannot think about one Sakhi. He is having what, eight Sakhi? And actually, if it is not installed, there is a different thing. You can go practice, but it is not installed. If it is installed, big problem. If some Mahapurush paying Dandavat, Ramanuja just speaking, if some Mahapurush touching the deity, offering flower, paying dandavat, then it become Patishthita. Follow. Install deity, you cannot ignore. You will have to do perfect seva. No, I can speak, but right not now. This is a Gita class. I can speak after. Cotton usually not pure. Cotton, if you touch somebody, silk, raw silk, everything pure. Follow, even in Grihastha room, you can find one cotton screen. So everybody coming, touching it. Touching means you can, maybe that man, follow, one second. Maybe I am, follow, one example I can give, not many. Suppose I am traveling in boat. Now you can put question, why Maharaj you are traveling untouched? How possible? Now point is that, if somebody coming from crematorium ground, burning ghat, follow what I say. He touched last burning there, he come in boat. I don't know, he touched me. I go and touch all my deity, everything, not possible. So automatically it's urgent, very, very 100% it is necessary. You have to change your clothes, take bath. It is my habit. Why? Because I know if I go outside, if touch me, then maybe they are in. They are doing some bad activities, maybe they are from wine shop, they are coming. Who can say? So I cannot believe. Straightway come, throw all my bag and baggage, everything, and clothes, everything, with clothes. In winter season also I take bath, 10 o'clock. I cannot go and sleep. This is my you can flow. I am not asking you to follow this system. If your health condition, everything can follow you,